So today we will start control and coordination. So in this chapter you learn, explain the role of nervous system and hormonal system in control and coordination of various activities of the body, recognize major components of the nervous system and enlist their functions, explain the role of nerve cells, neuron, in the transmission of nerve impulses, identify the location and explain the functions of spinal cord in evoking a reflex action, analyze the role of some of the endocrine glands in regulating our growth and behavior, appreciate the role and relevance of reflex, voluntary and involuntary actions, as well as hormones in efficient functioning of the body. So let us understand, what do you mean by hormones? Hormones are produced by specialized glands of endocrine system. So they are basically produced by the glands of endocrine system. When these hormones are produced, they are secreted directly into the blood. So hormones basically produced by the glands of endocrine system. What do you mean by endocrine system? So endocrine system consists of glands which do not have ducts, which do not have ducts to be produced in the body. Means they do not have a tube-like structures. They are secreted directly into the blood. Secreted in the sense, they are produced into the blood. So such kind of system is called as an endocrine system. So hormones are nothing but they are the secretions. Secretions andre adantara padartha iddage. So they are produced into the blood. It is with the help of for endocrine system, the whole nervous system works. So today in this class, we are studying about nervous system. So nervous system is basically works by the help of endocrine system. So at the right side, you have diagram. You have diagram of endocrine system. So the brain belongs to the endocrine system. So what is this brain? It do not have any tubes to produce the hormones. Hormones are produced directly into the blood. They do not have a tubes or any channels to produce the hormones. So we can say that brain and thyroid, these two belongs to the endocrine system. So let us study about the brain. So first and foremost, that is a neuron. Neuron is a nerve cell. What is a neuron? It is a smallest part of a brain. It is a cell of a brain. Every brain is made up of millions of neurons, millions of nerve cells. So at the right side, you have a diagram of neuron. We will study it in detail. So first and foremost, the neuron consists of dendrites. So first part is a dendrite. So what is it is? It receives the impulses and sets off a chemical reaction that creates an electrical impulses. So it will take the impulses. Take in the sense, adu togalutte. Impulse means any reaction. Any reaction it will take. Which one? That is a dendrite. It will receive the impulses and set off a chemical reaction. Means it will further transfer the impulse by creating an electrical impulse. It will transfer the message in the form of a electrical impulse, in the form of a electricity, you can say. It will transfer andre kalisutte. So dendrite is the one which will take the impulse and creates an impulse to transfer it through the neuron. The next one, we have cell body. So next important part of the neuron is a cell body. So what is the cell body? It transmits the impulse to the axon. It has a cell organelles like any other cells. So first, the impulse will be taken by the dendrites. So first and foremost, dendrite will take the impulse and it will transfer the impulse to the cell body. It will transfer the impulse to the cell body. Now, what is the job of cell body? This cell body will again transfer the impulse to the next part, that is an axon. It will transfer to the axon. Transfer in the sense, kalsutte. What does it transfer? Impulse. What is this impulse? Message, we can say. Any message, it will be sent. So, this cell body also has cell organelles. So, we have studied about the cell structure. Right, it has cell organelles like mitochondria, you can say, or it has a Golgi complex. So every whatever the cell has, it will also cell body also have all the cell organelles. So next important part of the neuron is axon. So third one is the important part is a axon. What is axon? It is the channel from the cyton to dendrite which transmit the signal. So what is this axon? Axon is nothing but it is like a channel. Channel in the sense it is like a tube, you can see there, right? It is just like a tube, long tube. Udda tube tara ide adu. From where to where? From the cyton. Cyton in the sense cell body is also called as a cyton. Cell body is also called as a cyton. So from the cyton up to the below, that is a axon terminal, up to the below. So this is a long tube, is a axon. This long tube like channel is called as a axon. Next we have neurilemma. So what is this neurilemma? The neuron is covered by an insulating fatty sheath. So you people might have understood electrical wire. So the electrical wire will be covered by some of the red or green color plastic coverings to prevent the electric shock. Similarly, here the neuron is covered by an insulating fatty sheath. It is covered by an insulating fatty sheath, and this fatty sheath, you can see their blue coloration. This fatty sheath is nothing but called as a neurilemma. What it is called? Neurilemma. So what is this neurilemma? Neurilemma enak irutte andre the impulse or a message horagade leak aagbardu anta, it will be the every neuron will be covered by a fatty sheath, that is called as a neurilemma. The next we have node of Ranvier. Next we have, that is a node of Ranvier. What is this? The intervals which are missing at a fatty sheath. So you can see there blue color idella, at the between we have a gap there, in between we have a gap there, right? So what is that gap? Intervals, we call it as a intervals, and this missing interval is called as a node of Ranvier. Idakke yaaki hesaru bantu andre, the Ranvier is the name of a scientist who has identified it, so he has given his name. Avan tanna hesaru kotta adakke what it is called as node of Ranvier. The next we have neurotransmitter. We will understand what do you mean by neurotransmitter. Neurotransmitter is nothing but the chemicals which are stored at the swollen end portion of axon terminals. So what is a neurotransmitter? Basically they are chemicals. Basically they are chemicals. Where they are stored? They are stored at the swollen portion. Swollen in the sense the bulge portion. Upkondiro portion genantivu navu, swollen portion. So the bulge portions of the axon where some chemicals are collected. So those are called neurotransmitters. The next sixth one, it is a synapse. What do you mean by synapse? It is nothing but the junction between the two neurons. So here I am showing you one neuron. Nave nortta idivi illi one neuron ide. When this neuron will go and connect with another neuron. Say for example, axon terminal will go and contact with the one more dendrite in a neuron barutte. So these two neurons, when they join together, the junction between them, the space between them is called as synapse. We have synaptic cleft. So we understood what is synapse. Synapse andre anta gotaytu. What do you mean by synaptic cleft? What do you mean by synaptic cleft? The space at the synapse separating the two neuron. So av eradu neuron join agiddak navu enantivi synapse antivi. Ad space between them there is certain space. So that space is called as a synaptic cleft. It is called as what? Synaptic cleft. So we understood about the neuron in detail. Now we will move upon to the types of neurons. We have three types of neurons. So at the right side you have diagram. We have three important types of neurons. Let us study what are those. The first one is sensory neuron. So what is the sensory neuron? The name itself suggests what it is. It will convey the impulse. Convey andre kalsutte. It will transfer, we can say. One more way, we can say transfer. It will convey the impulse from receptor. Receptor andre yen togolutto message avrige enantive receptor. Who is receptor here? Sense organ. It will convey the impulse from the sense organ to the main nervous system. Main nervous system means who are those? That is a brain and spinal cord. So what is the sensory neuron? Sensory neuron will convey, means it will transfer the impulse or it will transfer the message from the sense organ to the brain. It will transfer the message from the sense organ to the brain. Sense organ andre, like example, it may be skin. You may say we have five sense organs, right? The largest sense organ yavudu? Skin. So take an example of a skin. Like somebody pinches you, yaradru namge chutidre athwa yaradru somebody slaps you, so you will come to know. So it is a sensory neuron which will transfer the message from the skin to the brain. So you have a diagram here at the right side, the middle one. So middle one you have sensory neuron. So here melgade enide receptor cell anta ide red color, you can see there, right? So I have shown you receptor is nothing but I have given you example of a skin. So it is transferring the message from the sense organ up to the brain. It will transfer the message from the sense organ up to the brain. So we understood about sensory neuron. What is the important job? It will transfer the message from the sense organ to the brain or a spinal cord, that is nervous system. Now we will move upon to the motor neurons. What do you mean by motor neurons? So here it will carry the impulse. Impulse andre I already told you that is a message. Yene ondu message namge telisbekandre adike enantive impulse. It will carry the impulse from the main nervous system to an effector. To an effector. So illi enandre sensory neuron is opposite to motor neuron, exactly opposite. What is the job of motor neurons? It will carry the impulse from the brain nervous system to the muscles or a gland. See here, I will show you an example here. That is the first one I am showing you. So yaro obri athwa some, I will give you an example. When you keep your hand in a hot water, when you keep your hand in a hot water, what you will do? Suddenly you will remove your hand. En martira neevu kaina tagitira. Who has told you to remove the hand from the water? It is your brain. Brain has sent you message. How did it send the message? That is by the help of motor neuron. From the brain, the message, that is message is nothing but impulse, has sent to the muscle. Has sent to the muscle and suddenly you will remove the hand. So this is the job of motor neurons. Hope so you understood. The next one we will go, that is association, or it is also called connecting neurons. So it is a mediator job. Association neuron job, you know, it is a mediator. The association neurons are located in the brain and spinal cord and interconnect the sensory and motor neurons. So here association neuron kelsa eno andre, it will help the sensory neuron and the motor neuron to transfer the message from the brain to the muscle and from the muscle to the brain. So this is about the association neuron. So we understood the three types of neurons, that is sensory neuron, motor neuron and the association neurons. Like neurons, we also have three kinds of nerves. It is just like neurons, we have three kinds of nerves. That is, first one is sensory nerves. What is sensory nerves? The sensory nerves that contain the sensory fibers. These nerves bring the impulse again from the receptor, that is sense organ, to the spinal cord or the brain. So what we have example, that is optic nerve. Optic nerve arising from the eye and ending in the brain. Like how it is, example kodtini, enadru kannal dulvittu andre we will close the eyes, right? Suddenly we will close the eyes. Who has told to close the eyes? It is again the brain which will send the message to the optic nerve. So this is a sensory nerve. The next one we have, that is motor nerves. As we have said about motor neuron, similarly we have motor nerves. So motor nerves, which contain motor fibers, these nerves carry impulse from the brain or spinal cord to the effector organ like muscles or glands. Example, a nerve arising from the brain and carry the impulse to the muscles of the eye. The third one we have mixed nerves. So like association neuron, we have mixed nerves. So mixed nerves are those that contain both the sensory and the motor fibers and perform a mixed function. So they do the function of both the sensory and the motor. Inottara helbeku andre mixed nerves will help the sensory nerves and the motor nerves. Example, a spinal nerve. So we will study about the nervous system. Till now we have studied about the neurons. We studied structure of neuron, types of neurons and types of nerves, right? We will move on to the nervous system. What is nervous system? It is being divided into two systems. Nervous system is being divided into two systems. What are those? That is central nervous system and peripheral nervous system, right? We have two divisions. One is central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system. Right side you have a diagram. You can see that, right? We will study in detail. First one, central nervous system. It is also called as a CNS. Adan short aag navu enantivi CNS anta heltivi. So central nervous system, that includes brain and spinal cord. Basically central nervous system alli enen irutte? Brain and spinal cord. So diagram alli the dark orange color you can see there, right? So those two basically are CNS, that is brain and spinal cord. Next one is a peripheral nervous system. It is also called as a PNS. Enantha heltivi, it is also called PNS, which includes the nerves arising from the brain and spinal cord, right? That is light orange color. Diagram alli athara light orange color enideno aduk navu enantivi PNS. Yavde nerves spinal cord matte brain inda barutto avella they come under PNS, that is peripheral nervous system. So yav yav nerves barutte, cranial nerves or you can say spinal nerves or peripheral nerves, okay, also sensory neurons and motor neurons. Ivellavu yavudral barutte andre they come under peripheral nervous system, whereas brain, spinal cord iveradu matra they come under central nervous system. So first we will move to the central nervous system, adr bagge tilkolona, that is brain. So you can see the diagram of a brain, very nice beautiful diagram, that is brain, and its work is also very nice. The brain is a very delicate organ. It is very delicate organ. it is well protected within the bony cranium, that is the brain box. So brain is always located, it is protected, that is it is kept under a very strong substance called as a bony cranium. It is a bony cranium called as a brain box. So it is also covered above, it is covered by a skull. So namatha medulla ellu ittirthare, that is under the skull there is a bony cranium called as a brain box. It is further again bony cranium olagade ittmele adr melgade matte coverings ide. It is further protected by three meninges. It is protected by three meninges. Meninges andre enu, they are the membranous coverings. They are the membranous coverings. Ondara padar tara irutte, mooru padargalu ide brain mele. We have three layers, they are called as a meninges. They are also called as a membranous coverings, which continue backward over the spinal cord. Adu elli tanaka padargalu ide andre spinal cord tanaka cover agutte. They continue backward up to the spinal cord. So what is the spinal cord? You can see a handle like structure down one, right? So up to down it will be covered, that is spinal cord, right? So up to there we have meninges. So we will see what are these meninges. So these meninges are so first one is a dura mater. So you can see here at the right side diagram, you can see there ali ide nodi enandre, you can see a human being structure, right? So above it is been covered by a skull, right? Next we have cranium, we have next cranium. A cranium kelagade again under we have three layers, that is meninges. So we have three layers of membranes called as a meninges. The first one we will study, it is a dura mater. What is dura mater? The outermost tough fibrous membrane. The outermost andre the horagade irodu first covering ige nave enantivi dura mater. How it is very tough, adu bega hariyodilla. It is very tough, fibrous. It is not smooth, it is like a fibrous membrane. Next layer we have, that is arachnoid. Second layer nave enantivi arachnoid. How is this arachnoid? The arachnoid is the thin delicate middle layer giving a web like cushion. Arachnoid yav tara ide, it is very thin ade tumba tellagide, it is very thin, delicate in the sense it is very smooth. And middle layer nadugade ide, yav yav naduve pia mater matte dura mater nadugade yen barutte arachnoid giving a web like cushion. Cushion in the sense tumma mettagide, it is very soft web like cushion. So that is an arachnoid. The next layer we have, that is a pia mater, the last layer. That what are this? These are meninges we are studying. Pia mater, what is pia mater? The innermost highly vascular membrane, last membrane yavdu pia mater. It is highly vascular membrane. What do you mean by vascular? Vascular andre adralli rakta chalane aagta irutte. So in this membrane there will be a flow of blood, so we call it as vascular membrane. So these are three layers of the brain which will protect the brain, that is dura mater, arachnoid, pia mater. Dura mater is a tough membrane, arachnoid is very delicate membrane, and pia mater is a vascular membrane, means in which the blood will flow. Next we have above these all these membranes we have one more important component, that is called cerebrospinal fluid. Adre what is the cerebrospinal fluid? In between these three layers, that is dura mater, arachnoid and pia mater, there is a flow of a fluid. Fluid andre ondu liquid anta helbodu, we can say it is one of a liquid, like a water like liquid, which will be flowing in between these membranes, and that liquid is called as cerebrospinal fluid. What it is called? Cerebrospinal fluid. Like if we have any accident or if a person will fall, right? So the brain has been protected. from these membranes and the cerebrospinal fluid from any injuries. Okay, so till now we studied about the brain coverings, the above layer we studied. ಬ್ರೈನ್ ಮೇಲ್ಗಡೆ ಯಾವ ತರ ಕವರಿಂಗ್ ಇದೆ ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ನಾನು ಏನ್ ಹೇಳಿದೆ ಸ್ಕಲ್ ಆ ಸ್ಕಲ್ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಏನ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಕ್ರೇನಿಯಂ ಕ್ರೇನಿಯಂ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ತ್ರೀ ಲೇಯರ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆರ್ಕಿನಾಯ್ಡ್ ಪಿಯಾಮೆಟರ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಾಮೆಟರ್ ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೆರೆಬ್ರೋಸ್ಪೈನಲ್ ಫ್ಲೂಯಿಡ್ ನೌ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ನೌ ದಿಸ್ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ತ್ರೀ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ತ್ರೀ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದೋಸ್ ಸೆರೆಬ್ರಮ್ then cerebellum and medulla medulla is also called as brain stem it is also called as brain stem the first important part that is a cerebrum the very important yavudu cerebrum it is the largest portion of the brain right ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಸಿ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಕವರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಸೆರೆಬ್ರಮ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ರೈಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಲಾರ್ಜೆಸ್ಟ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ವರ್ಟಿಕಲಿ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಟೂ ಹಾಲ್ಸ್ ವರ್ಟಿಕಲಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು ಉದ್ದದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಉದ್ದದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಟೂ ಹಾಲ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎರಡು ಭಾಗವಾಗಿದೆ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದೋಸ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ರೈಟ್ ಸೆರೆಬ್ರಲ್ ಹೆಮಿಸ್ಫಿಯರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಸೆರೆಬ್ರಲ್ ಹೆಮಿಸ್ಫಿಯರ್ ಸೊ ಸೆರೆಬ್ರಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಲಾರ್ಜೆಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಅದೇನದು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಭಾಗವಾಗಿದೆ ಬ್ರೈನ್ದು ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫರ್ದರ್ ಬಿನ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಟೂ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಹಾಲ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಹೆಮಿಸ್ಫಿಯರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಹೆಮಿಸ್ಫಿಯರ್ ನೌ ಸೆರೆಬ್ರಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಸೀಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಟೆಲಿಜೆನ್ಸಿ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ತುಂಬಾ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಯೂಶಲಿ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಸೆರೆಬ್ರಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸೀಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಟೆಲಿಜೆನ್ಸಿ ಇಂಟೆಲಿಜೆನ್ಸಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಸೆರೆಬ್ರಮ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡೂ ಆಲ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸೆರೆಬ್ರಮ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಿಲ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಟೇಕ್ ದ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಜಡ್ಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅಥವಾ ಏನೇ ಒಂದು ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೇ ಆರ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸೀಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಮೊರಿ ಸೊ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಇಂಟೆಲಿಜೆನ್ಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಏನೇನಿದೆನೋ ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸೆರೆಬ್ರಮ್ ಸೊ ವಿ ಸೇ ದ ಸೆರೆಬ್ರಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಸೀಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಟೆಲಿಜೆನ್ಸ್ The next part we have cerebellum. So we studied about cerebrum. Next is cerebellum. The cerebellum is a much smaller area. Tumba chikkadadu. How it is? It is a much smaller area of the brain located below the cerebrum. So ellide adu below the andre cerebrum kelagade irode cerebellum. You can see the diagram, right? Cerebrum kelagade irode enudu cerebellum. It has no convolutions. ಕನ್ವಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಸಿ ದ ಸೆರೆಬ್ರಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಫೋಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಸಿ ದ ಫೋಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಸೆರೆಬ್ರಮ್ ಫೋಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮಡಿಕೆಗಳಿದಾವೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ರೈಟ್ ವೆರ್ ಆಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸೆರೆಬೆಲ್ಲಮ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಫೋಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸೇ ಕನ್ವಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ನೋ ಕನ್ವಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೆರೆಬೆಲ್ಲಮ್ ಬಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ನ್ಯೂಮರಸ್ ಫ್ಯೂರೋಸ್ ಫ್ಯೂರೋಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ತೆಗ್ಗುಗಳಿದೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬಾ ತೆಗ್ಗುಗಳು ರೈಟ್ We have so many furrows in the cerebellum, but there are no convolutions. It is meant for posture of the body. So cerebellum, the function, you know, it is meant for posture of the body. Means what? Like the balance of the body. Whenever a person is drunk, right? Yare obru kudidrandre, they cannot maintain the balance of the body. ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಸೆರೆಬೆಲ್ಲಮ್ ವಿಚ್ ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ಸ್ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ನೀವು ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ನಡಿಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅಥವಾ ನೀವು ಒಂದು ರೌಂಡ್ ತಿರುಗಿ ಸುತ್ತ ತಿರುಗಿದ್ರೆ ತಲೆ ಸುತ್ತ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಸೆರೆಬೆಲ್ಲಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಸೊ ಸೆರೆಬೆಲ್ಲಮ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ದ ಪೋಸ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಒಬಲಾಂಗುಟ ಸೊ ಮೆಡುಲಾ ಒಬಲಾಂಗುಟ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಮೆಡುಲಾ ಸೊ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಡಿ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಬೈ ತ್ರೀ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಮೆಡುಲಾ ಮೆಡುಲಾ ಒಬಲಾಂಗುಟ ಅಂಡ್ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ ದ ಮೆಡುಲಾ ಒಬಲಾಂಗುಟ ಈಸ್ ದ ಲೋಯೆಸ್ಟ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ಸೊ ಎಲ್ಲಿದೆ ಅದು ದ ಲೋಯೆಸ್ಟ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೊಕೇಟೆಡ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಬೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಕಲ್. ನಿಮ್ ತಲೆ ಬುರುಡೆಗೆ ಏನಂತೀವಿ ನಾವು? ಸ್ಕಲ್ ಅಂತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೊಕೇಟೆಡ್ ವೇರ್? ಅಟ್ ದ ಬೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಕಲ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಿಮ್ ಕುತ್ತಿಗೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತಲ್ಲ, ಹಿಂದ್ಗಡೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಫ್ಲಿ ಟ್ರಯಾಂಗುಲರ್. ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್? ರಫ್ಲಿ ಟ್ರಯಾಂಗುಲರ್, ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಟ್ರಯಾಂಗಲ್ ಶೇಪ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ, ರಫ್ಲಿ ಟ್ರಯಾಂಗುಲರ್, ತ್ರಿಕೋನ ಆಕಾರ. ಅಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಡ್ ಬಿಹೈಂಡ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೈನಲ್ ಕಾರ್ಡ್. ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಆಗಿದೆ? ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಡ್ ಬಿಹೈಂಡ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೈನಲ್ ಕಾರ್ಡ್. ನೌ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್? ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಟು ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ದ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ವಿಸ್ರಲ್ ಆರ್ಗನ್ಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ವಿಸ್ರಲ್ ಆರ್ಗನ್ಸ್? ಲೈಕ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟರಿ ಕೆನಾಲ್. ನೀವೇನೇ ಒಂದು ನುಂಗ್ತೀರಲ್ವಾ, ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಎನ್ಗಲ್ಫ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಫುಡ್, ರೈಟ್? ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಎನ್ಗಲ್ಫ್, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಸ್ಟಮಕ್. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ದ ಡೈಜೇಷನ್, ಹೂ ವಿಲ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ಟು ಎನ್ಗಲ್ಫ್? ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಮೆಡುಲಾ ಒಬ್ಲಾಂಗಟ, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ದ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವಿಸ್ರಲ್ ಆರ್ಗನ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟರಿ ಕೆನಾಲ್ ಮೂವ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಮೂವ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಒನ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಟು ಅನದರ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬೈ ಮೆಡುಲಾ ಒಬ್ಲಾಂಗಟ. ಬ್ರೀತಿಂಗ್, ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಬ್ರೀತ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಬೈ ದ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್. ಬೀಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೆನಿ ಅದರ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲೆಂಟರಿ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ವೇ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು, ಇನ್ವಾಲೆಂಟರಿ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ಇನ್ವಾಲೆಂಟರಿ? ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಅವರ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್, ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಅವರ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್. ನಮ್ಮ ಕೈಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಇರ್ಲಾರ್ದ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ನಾವೇನಂತೀವಿ? ಇನ್ವಾಲೆಂಟರಿ ಆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್. ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ವಿ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ದ ಬೀಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ಹಾರ್ಟ್? No, it is not possible, right? So such kind of actions are called involuntary actions. Now who will control all this? Medulla oblongata. So next we will see the functions of spinal cord. Iga brain stem kelagade barod yavudu, next part barod yavudu, that is a spinal cord. We will see the functions of spinal cord. So what is its first function? It controls the reflexes below the neck. So neck andre kuttige kela bhagadalli ene ondu reaction aitu andre adakke karana yaru? It is a spinal cord. Secondly, it conducts the sensory impulses from the skin and the muscles to the brain. Right? So we saw already the types of neurons all nodidvala, right? So it will conduct, who will conduct? Spinal cord will conduct the sensory impulses from the skin and the muscles to the brain. Nam body alli ene aadrunu adana brain ge kalisod yaru? Spinal cord. Thirdly, we have it conducts the motor responses from the brain to the muscles. ಈಗ ನಾವು ಏನೇ ಒಂದು ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಬಿಸಿನೀರಲ್ಲಿ ಕೈ ಇಟ್ಟರೆ ತೆಗಿ ಅಂತ ಕಳಿಸೋದು ಯಾರು ಮೆಸೇಜ್? ಅಗೇನ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಸ್ಪೈನಲ್ ಕಾರ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಬಾಡಿ ನಡುವೆ ಮೆಸೇಜ್ ಕಳಿಸೋದು ತಗೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಮಾಡೋದು ಯಾರು? ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ಪೈನಲ್ ಕಾರ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ಸ್ಪೈನಲ್ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬ್ರೈನ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಲರ್ನ್ಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಬ್ರೈನ್. So three important parts of the brain, that is cerebrum, cerebellum, brain stem, which is also called medulla oblongata. Then we learnt about spinal cord. Now we will move to the types of reflexes. Reflexes in the sense, you can say action and reaction. So reflexes alli eradu type ide. Yavudu yavudu? First one is a natural reflexes. First one is natural reflexes, which is also called inborn reflexes. And secondly, we have conditioned reflexes. It is also called acquired reflexes. Now, natural reflexes means what? We will learn about it. One example kottidare. Close your eyes and try to follow the rhythm of body, heart and pulse beating. Okay. All such activities in which no previous experience or learning is required are termed as natural reflexes. So what do you mean by natural reflexes means? did you learn to beat your heart? Nav ellindadru kalthidiva heart beat maadkolodu, right? We have not learned. We have got it from the birth. Every child is born with the beating of the heart naturally, right? So such kind of actions is called as a natural reflexes, that is inborn reflexes, where we have not learned from the previous experience, right? All such activities in which no previous experience or learning is required, it is termed as natural reflexes. Secondly, we have conditioned reflexes, just opposite to it. Salivation occurs at the smell of the food, as the brain is able to remember the taste of the food and works in an unconscious way. Such reflexes are not inborn, and hence conditioned reflexes are acquired. So here I will give you an example, that is a salivation. ಈಗ ಕೆಲವೊಬ್ಬರಿಗೆ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಸ್ಮೆಲ್ ಇಷ್ಟ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಸಮ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದ ಸ್ಮೆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಪೇಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಮ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದ ಸ್ಮೆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಪೇಂಟ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಸ್ಮೆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫುಡ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ರೈಟ್? ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಅನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಪೇಂಟ್, ರೈಟ್? ಈಗ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ಸ್ಮೆಲ್ ಇಷ್ಟ ಆಯ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ತಗೊಳ್ತೀವಿ ಅದನ್ನ, ಬಟ್ ಸಮ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ದರ್ ನೋಸ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಸ್ಮೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಸ್. ಇಟ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಅಸ್. ನಮಗೆ ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಬೇಡ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಬಿಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಸಚ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಸಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಲರ್ನ್ಡ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಅಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್, ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಸ್, ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಅಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಸ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ಇದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಏನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸಲೈವೇಷನ್ ಅಕ್ಕಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಊಟ ನೋಡಿದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಅದನ್ನ ತಿನ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಆಸೆ ಆಗತ್ತೆ. ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಫುಡ್, ರೈಟ್? ಒಬ್ಬರೊಬ್ಬರಿಗೆ ಒಂದೊಂದು ಊಟ ಇಷ್ಟ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. So each person likes the different food and to show the reaction. So this reaction is called as conditioned reflex. Okay, we learned about the central nervous system till now, right? Starting central nervous system, peripheral nervous system. ಸೆಂಟ್ರಲ್ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವೇನ್ ಓದಿದ್ವಿ, ವಿ ಲರ್ನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಬ್ರೈನ್, ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಸಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಬ್ರೈನ್. ನೌ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಮೂವ್ ಟು ದ ಪೆರಿಫರಲ್ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ದ ಪೆರಿಫರಲ್ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೂ ಸಬ್ ಡಿವಿಷನ್ಸ್. ಇದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಿದೆ, ಟೂ ಡಿವಿಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್. ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದೋಸ್? ಸೊಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ವಾಟ್? ಸೊಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ನರ್ವಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ವಾಟ್ ಡಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಡೂ? The somatic nervous system conveys the information from the brain and spinal cord to the skeletal muscles and regulates the voluntary actions. So yede ondu motor actions nam body al agutte andre, so it is meant by the somatic nervous system. So it will convey the information, andre message ellinda kalisutte, from the brain and spinal cord to the skeletal muscles and other voluntary actions. Voluntary actions in the sense, whatever you will do from your muscles, say moving your hand or walking from one place to another place or talking to someone. So these all are examples for voluntary actions. Idrella maadsod yaro andre somatic nervous system. Next one we have autonomic nervous system. What it is? Autonomic nervous system. What it is? It will control the involuntary action of many internal organs, smooth muscles, heart muscles and glands, right? All the involuntary actions. Involuntary andre nama dehada olagade iro ella organs na function maadsod yaru? Autonomic nervous system. Example, heart. Heart beat agbeku andre yar heltare? That is again autonomic nervous system. Okay, so whenever you drink something, right, the stomach will start the digestion. Who will tell? It is autonomic nervous system, right? So whenever you breathe, your lungs starts functioning. Again, who will say? Autonomic nervous system. So all internal organs, valagade iro organs ella function maadsod yaro? Autonomic nervous system. So in the somatic nervous system, so we learned what is somatic nervous system, which controls all the voluntary actions. This consists of again two sets of neurons. Somatic nervous system alli erdu set of nerves ide. Yavdu yavdu? One is the cranial nerves, another is a spinal nerves. What are those? That is a cranial nerves and the spinal nerves. Now, 12 pairs of cranial nerves. Yesterday, 12 pairs. 12 pairs of cranial nerves will emerge from the brain. Ellinda emerge andre eno ellinda hutkolutte anta artha. So from where they emerge, they come from the brain. For example, cranial nerves ke example yavdu optic nerve for eyes and auditory nerves for ears. Like you will talk, we will see, we will hear, we will smell, alva kannu mugu bayi kivi ivellaku nerves brain ge connect agide ivella nerves ke naave enantivi cranial nerves. So how many are there? 12 pairs we have. Next we have spinal nerves. So spinal nerves yestidave 31 pairs we have. How many? 31 pairs of spinal nerves which emerge from the spinal cord. Andre facial iro nerves ella comes under cranial, bere ella body alliro nerves ella comes under what? It comes under, that is a spinal nerves. How many spinal nerves we have? 31 pairs. Ellinda emerge agutte? From the spinal cord. Very important. Cranial nerves emerge from brain and spinal nerves emerge from the spinal cord. Yes, very important part, that is a pituitary gland. We learned about central nervous system, we learned our peripheral nervous system. Brain alli one important gland ide, what it is called, that is a pituitary gland. Pituitary gland ge innond hesaru ide, it is called mother gland. It is also called mother gland. So in the diagram you can see here pituitary, the dark blue ball like structure, very small it is actually. Very small dark blue like structure, hypothalamus kelagadane barutte pituitary, right? It is, though it is very small, adu tumba functions jaasti ide. So it will produce almost all the hormones in our body, so we call it as mother gland. It is called as what? Mother gland. This is a small gland. Pituitary gland is a small gland located at the base of the brain. So ellide adu? Base of the brain. This gland plays an important role. It plays a very important role in the growth of a child from the puberty to the full reproductive maturity, right? Yavade vandu child, any child is born from the birth up to the maturity tanka yavade hormone produce aitondre, it is by the help of pituitary. So pituitary produces most of the hormones. We say it is a mother gland. ಏನಂತೀವಿ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ? ಮದರ್ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಡಿಸೀಸಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ನ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ಸ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಕುಷಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಡಿಸೀಸ್. ಏನಂತೀವಿ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ? ಕುಷಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಡಿಸೀಸ್. ಸೊ ಈ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ಯಾಕೆ ಬರುತ್ತಂದ್ರೆ, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಹೈಪರ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಪಿಟ್ಯುಟರಿ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಹೈಪರ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ತುಂಬಾ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತು ಪಿಟ್ಯುಟರಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವೇನಂತೀವಿ ಹೈಪರ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪಿಟ್ಯುಟರಿ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಇನ್ ದ ಮೇಲ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಲೀಡ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸೆಸಿವ್ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೇರ್. ಸೊ ಒಂದು ಸಿಂಪ್ಟಮ್ಸ್ ಏನು ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಮೇಲ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎಕ್ಸೆಸಿವ್ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೇರ್ ಕಾಣ್ಕೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತೆ. ಯಾವುದಕ್ಕೆ? ಕುಷಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಡಿಸೀಸ್. ಸೊ ವೈ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೈಪರ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಪಿಟ್ಯುಟರಿ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್. The next important disease is the dwarfism. What it is called? Dwarfism. It is the deficiency. Deficiency is also called hypoactivity. Andre kammi iradakke enanthivu namu deficiency antivi. The hypoactivity of growth hormone. Growth hormone kammi produce aitu andre enagutte? That is dwarfism agutte. The growth hormone is also called as somatotropic hormone. It is also called as a somatotropic hormone. ಈ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ ಯಾರು ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ? ಅಗೇನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಪಿಟ್ಯುಟರಿ. ಸೊ ಪಿಟ್ಯುಟರಿ ಹೈಪರ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಆಯ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕುಷಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೈಪೋ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ, ಲೆಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಆಯ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಅಗೇನ್? ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಡ್ರಾಫಿಸಮ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ದ ಡೆಫಿಷಿಯನ್ಸಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ಡ್ರಾಫಿಸಮ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, The person will be very short, stunted growth. Kulligirtharalla thumba kulligiravaru enanthe we say it is a dwarfism. Next one is a gigantism. That is opposite to the dwarfism is a gigantism. Excessive secretion of growth hormone. So illi enagutte growth hormone jaasti produce aayitu andre it is called gigantism. ತುಂಬಾ ಉದ್ದ ಬೆಳೆದ್ರು ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟೂ ಮಚ್ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನಿ ಮಸಲ್ ಆರ್ ಟೂ ಮಚ್ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ದ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಗಿಗ್ಯಾಂಟಿಸಮ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪಿಟ್ಯೂಟರಿ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ Next gland is very important, that is a thyroid gland. Till now we discussed about pituitary gland and its concerned diseases. Now we'll move to the thyroid gland. So what is this thyroid gland? It is responsible for the speed of metabolism in our body. So thyroid gland will help for the metabolism. Metabolism andre digestion, respiration, right? Excretion, ivella enakke, that is digestion andre jeerna agodu. Right, respiration, usirata, ivelladu yar karana, that is again a thyroid gland in our body. The thyroid gland is essential for life, growth and development. So namma dehadalli ene ondu belavadige aagbekandre it is because of thyroid gland. So thyroid gland indanu we will have some of the diseases. Like pituitarily now nodidvala we have three diseases Cushing's disease dwarfism gigantism adhe tara thyroid allo we have some of the diseases first one yavdu that is a hyperthyroidism hyper andre eno jaasti hyper andre jaasti so what is hyperthyroidism when the thyroid gland becomes overactive andre tumba active aitu thyroid andre and produces more thyroid hormones right produces more thyroid hormones than it is necessary for optimal functioning the condition is called hyperthyroidism so bekagirodarkintu jaasti thyroid hormone produce aitu andre aa condition ig nav enuttivi hyperthyroidism the next one we have hypothyroidism The what it is hypothyroidism when the thyroid gland becomes underactive and produces less thyroid hormone than necessary the condition is called hypothyroidism ಎಷ್ಟು ಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು ಅದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಕಮ್ಮಿ gland produce ಆಯ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕಮ್ಮಿ thyroid hormone produce ಆಯ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಏನಂತೀವಿ hypothyroidism Okay, we will learn the diseases concerned with the hypothyroidism and hyperthyroidism. First one is the cretinism. It was disease hesaru. What it is? Cretinism. Cretinism is a condition of severely stunted physical and mental growth due to untreated congenital deficiency of thyroid hormone. That is hypothyroidism or from prolonged nutritional deficiency of iodine okay we will understand cretinism andre eno adu one condition what is that condition alli enagutte andre the person will have stunted physical and mental growth andre physically dehada belavanige as well as mentally means brain also will not develop such condition is a cretinism so cretinism yak barutte andre it is due to less production of thyroid hormone that is hypothyroidism and it is always congenital congenital andre it will transfer from generation to generation aduke enuttu navu congenital that is congenital deficiency of thyroid hormone or cretinism inond karanakku barutte yakandre it is due to the deficiency of iodine it is due to the deficiency of iodine adike heltare uppu tinbeku baala kammi uppu tinbardu antu heltare right so the iodine comes from salt most of the advertisements we see it comes from the salt so due to the deficiency of iodine also we will have cretinism the next disease that is goiter ಇದನ್ನ ಕೇಳಿರ್ಬೇಕು ಗೋಯಿಟರ್ ಅಂತ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಬಬ್ಲಿ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಹರ್ಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಗೋಯಿಟರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಥೈರಾಯ್ಡ್ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರೈಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಅನ್ ಎನ್ಲಾರ್ಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ visible externally as a swelling on the front of the neck. So ನೀವು ನೋಡಿರ್ಬೋದು ಕೆಲವೊಬ್ರು ನೆಕ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ ಹಾಕೊಳ್ತಾರೆ ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ವೆಲಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫ್ರಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ ರೈಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ದ ಎನ್ಲಾರ್ಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಥೈರಾಯ್ಡ್ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಗೋಯಿಟರ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಡಿಫಿಷಿಯನ್ಸಿ ಆಫ್ ಅಯೋಡಿನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಡೈಟ್ ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಗೋಯಿಟರ್ ಯಾಕೆ ಬರುತ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಥೈರಾಯ್ಡ್ Due to the excess production of thyroid, there is an enlargement of a thyroid gland called as a goiter. Cretinism yak varatandre due to less production of thyroid. So cretinism is because of hypothyroidism, goiter is because of hyperthyroidism. So next gland we have that is a pancreas. So we are learning about two glands we learned. One is a pituitary gland we learned. Next one we learned about thyroid gland. Next we will move to the pancreas. So what is this pancreas? This gland secretes two hormones. Pancreas en madutte? It produces the two hormones. Secretes andre enu horagade bidutte. Adakke antivi secretes. Two hormones. What are those? Insulin. Very important. Insulin and glucagon. It produces two hormones, that is insulin and glucagon, which help. What is their function? It will help in the metabolism of glucose in our body. What do you mean by metabolism? Metabolism andre glucose na correct agi maintain madutte body alli. Yav yav two hormones. One the insulin, one more is a glucagon. Glucose andre sugar level, you can say. ಶುಗರ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ನ ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಯಾರ್ಯಾರು ಇನ್ಸುಲಿನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಗ್ಲೂಕಾಗಾನ್ ಸೊ ಕನ್ಸರ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಡಯಾಬಿಟಿಸ್ ಮೆಲಿಟಿಸ್ ಸೊ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ನೋ ಡಯಾಬಿಟಿಸ್ ಪೇಷಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ನೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಯಾಬಿಟಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಯಾಬಿಟಿಸ್ ಮೆಲಿಟಿಸ್ ಸೊ ವೈ ದಿಸ್ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಹೈಪೋ ಸಿಕ್ರೀಷನ್ ಹೈಪೋ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಐ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು ಲೆಸ್ ಸಿಕ್ರೀಷನ್ Due to the hyposecretion of insulin causes the diabetes mellitus in which the glucose is present in excess in the body. So, yavage insulin kammi produce agutho body alli, yen agutte glucose level jasti agutte. The glucose will be excess in the blood and that condition is called as a diabetes mellitus. Adike naavu helthe sugar level jasti aitu diabetes alli, right? So why sugar level will increase? Because insulin has decreased in the body. So we learned about the most important three glands. We will complete. Now we will move to the question and answers part. Okay. If a pathologist were to collect a hormone, where would it be collected from? So yeah, you know, a pathologist. Who is a pathologist? Who want to learn about any disease or any deficiency? Nimma body alli eno ondu problem ide anta nodorige anante pathologist. So if want to collect a hormone, from where he will collect? Is it from the blood, brain, or specific endocrine gland, or any part of the body? Ellinda collect martane? ಹಾರ್ಮೋನ್ನ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ಇಂದ ಬ್ರೇನ್ ಇಂದ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕ್ ಎಂಡೋಕ್ರೈನ್ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆರ್ ಎನಿ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಸೊ ಎನಿ ಆನ್ಸರ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಓಕೆ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅನ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಬ್ರೇನ್ ಸೊ ಓಕೆ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ವಿ ಟೇಕ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಬ್ರೇನ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಓಕೆ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಬ್ಲಡ್ ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್ ಕಾವ್ಯ Exactly, the answer that is first option, he will collect from the blood. Okay, second we have hyperactivity of pituitary gland causes. We learned hyperactivity. What do you mean by hyper? Excess activity of pituitary gland causes. We have options, dwarfism, gigantism, Cushing's disease or cretinism. So we learnt about it. Okay. So gigantism. Okay, we got an option that is cretinism. So you think answer exactly. Read the question properly. Yes, exactly. That is Cushing's disease. Option C, that is a Cushing's disease. They are asking hyperactivity of pituitary gland. They are not asking hyperactivity of the growth hormone. If they ask growth hormone, we can go for the option B, that is a gigantism. The neurons that carry impulses from sense organ to the brain or spinal cord are. So read the question properly. The neurons that carry the impulses from the sense organs to the brain or spinal cord are. So what are those neurons? They are sensory neuron, motor neuron, association neuron, or connecting neuron. So who will carry the impulses? Yes, exactly, Vasha, that is sensory neuron. Exactly, Kavya, that is first option. They will carry the impulse from the sense organ to the brain or the spinal cord. Whereas the opposite, from the brain and spinal cord to the motor, is transferred by the motor neurons. So first option, that is sensory neuron. The parts of reflex are connected to. So we have learnt about the so many reflexes, right? So the parts of reflexes are basically connected to. Yelli connect agirutte. They are connected to brain, spinal cord. Yes. Both brain and spinal cord as synapse. Exactly the option C. I have got two answers. That is C option. Both brain and spinal cord. Rangaswamy, very good. That is both brain and spinal cord. Two neurons are connected to each other through. So very first part we discussed about it, how they are connected. Two neurons, they're connected through their axons, their dendrons, the dendrites of first neuron and the dendrite of the second one, or is it by synapse? Okay, Kavya, it is by C. See, we learned about it, right? Just go back to here, this one, whatever you learned, how they are connected through their axons, their dendrons, the dendrite of first neuron and the dendrite of second one, or is it by synapse? It is not the C option. Okay, it is by synapse. We learned now the junction, those two neurons have been connected through a junction called as synapse, and the space between the junction is called as a synaptic cleft. We learned about it, right? So how they are connected through? They are connected through the synapse. An axon is. So we learnt about axon, right? So what is an axon? An axon is a nerve fiber. Is it a nerve fiber? Or is it a bundle of dendrites? Or a bundle of nerve fibers? Or is it a sheath of a nerve fiber? An axon is a nerve. Is it simply a nerve fiber? A bundle of dendrites? A bundle of nerve fibers? Or is it a sheath of a nerve fiber? Okay, Arvind Raj, we got an option. It is a nerve fiber. Okay. It is just a nerve fiber. It don't have anything. Okay. It's the last option, that is a sheath of nerve fiber. We have learned about it, right? It has a sheath. I have given you an example of an electric wire, right? It has a covering of a sheath over it. To prevent what? To prevent the leakage of impulses, right? So we can say it is the last option, the sheath of a nerve fiber. Okay. Read the question properly. An individual reported to the neurophysician with a body temperature much higher than normal. After several investigations, the neurophysician diagnosed that a tumor in a specific area of the brain was causing this symptom. Where do you think the tumor may have been located? So what is the question? A patient has come to a doctor. He has a high body temperature. Normal kintu tumba body high temperature itto. So after several investigation, after several tests, what did he say? The physician told that the tumor is there. He told there is a tumor in a specific area of the brain. Brain al one kade tumor ide, which caused because of high temperature. ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಏನಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಬಾಡಿ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಏರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ವೇರ್ ಡೂ ಯು ಥಿಂಕ್ ದ ಟ್ಯೂಮರ್ ಮೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿನ್ ಲೊಕೇಟೆಡ್? ಸೊ ಟ್ಯೂಮರ್ ಎಲ್ಲಾಗಿರ್ಬೋದು? ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆರೆಬ್ರಮ್, ಸೆರೆಬೆಲ್ಲಮ್, ಹೈಪೋಥಾಲಮಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡೈಎನ್ಸೆಫಲಾನ್? ವೇರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಲೊಕೇಟೆಡ್? ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ ಸೆರೆಬ್ರಮ್ ಆರ್ ಸೆರೆಬೆಲ್ಲಮ್? ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೆರೆಬ್ರಮ್. See, cerebrum is meant for, we already learned, it is meant for intelligence. Cerebellum is meant for the maintenance of the body posture. Okay, very good. From Kavya we got that is hypothalamus. So option C. See, hypothalamus is a one which is meant to maintain the body temperature. Which is meant to the maintenance of body temperature. So we can say that is option C is correct, because cerebrum is meant for intelligence, cerebellum is meant for what? It is for posture. So the option C, that is the hypothalamus. Where is the subconscious mind located? So where it is located, subconscious mind, you have an options, four options you have: thalamus, hypothalamus, cerebellum and cerebrum. Okay, Varshas, thalamus I have got from Rangaswamy, cerebrum, very good. So right answer, that is a cerebrum. So we have already told now that is site of intelligence, it is a cerebrum. So subconscious mind is located basically in the cerebrum. The tissue in man where no cell division occurs after birth is. So yavudo ond magu huttidre alli further belavanige agodilla, there is no further cell division. Where it is? Is it in the skeletal tissue, or is it a nerve tissue, or is it a connective tissue or germinal tissue? Okay, Arvind Raj, we have germinal tissue. Varsha, that is a nerve tissue. Exactly, it is what? That is obviously it is a nerve. See, whenever a child is born, it is a brain which will further development will takes place from our outside activities. So nerves will not actually divide further, they will always develop, right? See, we have an explanation here, let us go through it. A nerve is an enclosed cable like bundle of axons, that is a long slender projections of neurons in the peripheral nervous system. A nerve provides a common pathway for electrochemical nerve impulses that are transmitted along each of the axon to the peripheral organs. So here, what is the job of nerve? It only transfers the message. So there is no further divisions of the nerves. So they only develop. They are asking where further cell division will not occur. So it is the nerves where the further cell division will not occur. The body temperature is regulated by. So here we have. The temperature of the body is regulated by. Okay, very good. From Kavya, we got a second option very fast. That is pituitary gland, hypothalamus, pineal gland, and thyroid gland. We learned about all the glands, right? So pituitary gland, hypothalamus gland, pineal gland, thyroid gland. The right answer is hypothalamus. Hypothalamus is a portion of a brain that contains a number of small nuclei with a variety of functions. One of the most important function of hypothalamus is to link the nervous system to the endocrine system via the pituitary gland, that is hypophysis. So it is one of the linkage between the nervous system and the pituitary. What is its main important function is to maintain the body temperature. Which amongst the following is the largest endocrine gland in the body? So we learned about endocrine system at the starting, right? So they are asking which is the largest endocrine gland. Thyroid, parathyroid, adrenal gland, or it is a pituitary gland. So exactly, Rangaswamy, we got the answer, that is a thyroid gland. So thyroid gland is one of the largest gland of a endocrine system. Endocrine glands are the glands of endocrine system that secrete their products in the sense hormones, directly into the blood rather than through the duct. Duct andre, it is a channel, as I told you already. The main endocrine glands include some examples of endocrine gland like pituitary gland, pancreas, ovaries, testes, thyroid gland and adrenal glands. So these are the examples for endocrine gland. Means they will not secrete through the duct. They release directly into the blood hormones. Okay. The thyroid gland in vertebrate anatomy, means in a vertebrate organism, is one of the largest endocrine gland. Which one it is the largest? That is a thyroid. Okay, we'll move to the conclusion part. So let us review once what all we learned. Explain the role of nervous system and hormonal system in control and coordination of various activities of the body. And we recognized major components of nervous system and enlisted their functions. We also explained the role of nerves. So we learned about neuron, right? In the transmission of nerve impulses, and identify the location and explain the functions of spinal cord in evoking a reflex action, and analyze the role of some of the endocrine glands. We learned some of the endocrine glands, right? Like pituitary, right? Thyroid, in regulating our growth and behavior, and appreciate the role and relevance of reflex, voluntary and involuntary actions, as well as hormones, in efficient functioning of the human body. So these all we learned in this topic. So if you have any doubts, you are welcome. Any queries about this chapter, you can ask. Please visit edurapid.com website. You have so many questions and practice the questions on that. So if you have any queries, please ask. You are always welcome. Okay, thank you all.